morning, ladies and gentlemen. After these two fantastic speeches, I have a new challenge. But first of all, I would like to thank you, Stefan, Nika, and Peter for the invitation to this symposium, a very interesting conference. And because also I know that part of you never been to Poland, let me introduce Poland that you maybe better understand our system and our way to go to this present situation we have. Our population is almost 40 million, Poles living in Poland and 20 million living abroad. The biggest Polish town is our capital, Warsaw. Well, maybe some other know who is the biggest second Polish town. Chicago. I don't know how many Poles live in London and what is the position of London. Sorry for that. Polish common economy is the one of the fastest growing economy in not only Europe but also in the world. Our GDP, comparing year to year, is now on a level of 4.5 to 4.8%, depends on sources. We have the lowest level of unemployment ever. It's lower than 5%, so that it creates a lot of problems with a lack of employees, a lack of staff in our fast developing companies and industry. Maybe say also a reason why our government accept 2 million immigrants from Ukraine, who are living in Poland and work mostly in building construction industry. Partly also in the lift industry, but it's another question, another story. talking about our industry, lift industry, that we have more than 600,000 handicap equipment, including 130,000 lifts. Every year is near 7,000 new installment, and we have also 1,500 lifts modernized every year. So it's a lot. We have only 4,000 employees working in our branch, and of course we have a huge lack of employees. Also now it's a huge pressure on the increasing salaries. Maybe you should create an understatement because we are now in election in our parliament and a lot of policing. And one of the policies says that minimum salary in Poland would be almost 1,000 euro within 2023, I hope. So, on our market operate Big Four, they have a biggest part of the biggest share of the market, and near 500 small one family companies, mainly operating in maintenance of the lifts. Of course, our industry is a high technology industry. I think we have the newest stock in Europe, because 60% of our lifts were installed after our accession to the European Union after 2004, in accordance to the lift directive. So we have this very, very modern stock. No, lift mechanic, what is one of the most important for us, is a regulated professor, a profession required for passing the state exams. I would like also say that the education system in each country is shaped by many years of tradition, cultural conditions, and state policy. In case of the country vocational education, the conditions result from industrial culture, and its condition must also be taken into account. In Poland, as a result of the system transformation from the communist economy to the market economy after 1989, there was a huge restructuring of and privatization of state-owned enterprises, many of these enterprises went bankrupt or split into smaller units. I should say that privatization was stopped 3 or 4 years ago, in 2015, by our government. At the same time, many of these enterprises, at the same time, vocational school are liquidated because this school belongs to the enterprises. So, also, in addition, the number of secondary school was also had problems with the practice for the students because of reduction of and liquidation of this big companies. The political and economic situation in the years 1990 to 2004 causes a growing problem with the recruitment of employees by companies, especially in the area of advanced technology. In addition, the lack of employees results from enormous migration process after Poland's accession to the European Union. Over 2 million Poles, young Poles, left Poland, which depended the fatal demographic situation in our country. In addition, the reform of the vocational education system causes the outflow of young people from vocational education school. The reform of the public vocational education system has been in Poland for 20 years. After 20 years, we return to the system that was in Poland before the reform in 1999. Well, maybe in the same place, but the system now is almost the same like 20 years ago. This reform ruined the vocational education system due to close down a large number of basic vocational schools, and also second technical school. You may see there some kinds of milestone of this education system. It means that from start in 1999, we were involved in the education program in 2004 when we established a kind of a relation with the school. Amendment to the Education Act forbid us to continue our program because there was no profession accepted by the Ministry of Education. In 2017, which means 2 years ago, it was entered into force into new law regulation, and as you see, a year ago, it was established new system of basic vocational schools, stage one, stage phase of sectoral vocational schools. Now, in 2019, start secondary school, which takes 5 years of education instead of 4 years which were in the past. And next year, we'll start the stage second sectoral vocational school, which will take 2 or 3 years of education. Our curriculum was implemented as a specialization for registered profession, and there was no profession at that time of lifting equipment, technical in the public education system. So that we chose this three specialization: electrical, technical, mechanical, mechatronics, technicians, and electronic technicians. We meet as a professional program of specialization, so that we apply for the structural funds from the European Union. We got the subsidy on the level of 250,000 euro, and so that we develop a program of specialization. We use the employees keep modern methodology model because for us it was the most challenging, I think, methodology also for students, like also for the teachers. And the implementation of such model into the secondary school, this was also a challenge. This program was divided into 10 modules, and 10 modules were divided into the 40 training units, total 210 hours. We also have to give the students some practical parts in the employees. Our students also passed the state school. It is very interesting and important. At the secondary school, they passed two state exams. First, it was a certificate for the maintenance up to 1 kilowatt done by Polish Association of Electrical, and second was that they passed in grade 4 the maintenance awarded the category certificate qualification for the lift industry. I don't want to maybe go into the details of this module, but this is a list of modules and if somebody would be interested, we can also later maybe share some more detailed information. But this scope, I think, will cover all of our needs for the specialization for the students who were teaching electrician or mechanical or electronics technicians. Unfortunately, when we completed our program, which was paid by European Union Fund, it was a new amendment to the Education Act, and we couldn't continue our specialization program from 2014. So we have to develop a new profession. We have to develop a new profession, lift equipment technician, which has to be approved by Ministry of Economy of Poland and also Minister of Education. So when this new profession we established, it took us 2 years. We will be allowed to continue our program of in this public schools. Of course, we were involved as an association to prepare the basic education program, curriculum to the profession, and qualification exams. Our experts were working through the officials from the Ministry of Education of Poland. Of course, I think the common goals with education, which we also try to achieve for our students, that mounting lifting devices, maintenance, organization of work, and so on and so on. What we deliver now it's to the school, it's years 2015-2019, it's a secondary technical school on the grade 2. It's a 17 professional practice in the companies, 1 day a week. It's according to the system. And in grade 3, it's a 30 days professional practice in companies. This year start, as I mentioned, new system of secondary technical school. And we succeeded the recruitment to the school. We got now 100 students. So it's quite successful on the Polish condition. Next year we'll start also, we are working on it, this stage second sectoral vocational schools, and we try to adjust our system also to this school. We are also involved in many action for the promotion and support promotion schools and support schools and. We produce, we translated into Polish ELA documents. Also, we produce our textbook about the hydraulics. Where's the bell? like this one, this is hydraulics list, and we also prepare the code of the best practice for the maintenance, so that we split also between the companies and students. Other our action is, of course, we promote schools and professions together in education fairs, open days, technology days, seminars, websites, Facebook as well. We also deliver to the to these laboratories, schools, the lifting equipment and some models. Some of them also are purchased by schools using the structural funds, and which are in the budgetary with municipal local municipalities. There are also kinds of patronage workshop. The companies make a patronage on the classrooms. There are our schools split in all around in Poland. So it's maybe not a lot, but it's a challenge for us, I think. Conclusion. The vocational training program in the postgraduate school is implemented within 4 years. It's required political stability. As you see in our example, there are no political stability in Poland, so that is a huge influence on our work. And also, we have to adjust maybe every 2 years to the new system. Not only in our association, our expert, our companies, but also schools. Because our students are young, they start education, they are 15 years old. So that a huge influence on their decision have also parents. So it's also our task to convince the parents. And that our trench, our industry is a challenging industry, so that is the word to educate in this way and work in the future, because it's a long life, I think, work. of course, as I mentioned, we have to adapt together, the schools and our association, to change in the education systems. But of course, also our members and lift companies, they have to also adapt to the new systems, and also because we have younger students. Also, it's difficult to adapt to the regulation about the safety of workers. It's and so thank you very much for your attention.